Recording, master started.
Audio?
Audio is fine, yeah.
Okay. So, the first question is.
Let me just do that once
Yeah.
again, the earlier one.
Masks.
Right?
Masks.
Masks.
Masks?
Masks.
Masks.
Sorry, one sec. Masks.
Yes.
Masks. Oh, do it, sit, do it. Do it now. Okay, yeah. So, sorry, say that again, please. Was that correct?
Yes, we got it, we got it.
So we're under severe lockdown in Mumbai, and this is a very makeshift desk right now. It all started with a lot of stress. There was wonder, there was a thought that what's going to happen to the businesses, to the people who work with us, to us staying at home and everything getting shut. I thought to myself, I don't want to continue thinking what's going to happen, what's going to happen. Let me make it into an opportunity to get healthier and also look back. So I made it into an exercise of every day looking at my fashion shows and kind of objectively looking at my work. It turned out to be a journey into the past and a lot of good time with my mother discussing my childhood, her childhood.
One second.
Thank you.
In senior KG, she got me a tuition teacher because she wanted my English to be really good. And the tuition teacher after a month told her that, but what can I teach him because he's constantly talking about my shoes and my dress and it doesn't match. And she said, at times I used to be stressed that you're going to comment on my dressing. And you were someone who was very straightforward. You would say what you are feeling. For me, design is happiness. Design is celebration. There is a certain positive, happy rush that I feel when there's something creative. And I think that comes from the fact when I saw movies and I used to see all good-looking characters, beautiful clothes, lovely music, all of it made me happy and I kept going back to it. I enjoy the fact that somebody takes that outfit and is sparkling and feels good, feels pretty. Even when I was criticized, I went on with what I did. Like I was, you know, given the tag Bollywood. While everybody followed what I did, which was having actors wear the clothes. And for me, it was always an organic process because I worked with them in movies. But later on, I started realizing that whatever I consistently did become a trend. So sequins and glitter and glamour is attempted by every kind of designer today. So I started owning up Bollywood. I said, yes, I have come from Bollywood. The day and night work my assistants or my tailors, my embroiderers have done with me, that to me is something that I can never ever forget. We definitely do a lot of work in Kashmir, from the zari, the tilla, to the thread work. A lot of work of chikankari in Mijma, which is a small village in Azamgarh in UP. The movies, for example, even if you pick up clothes, and I used to always remake them. Imagine all of that opening, making again, or alterations that come last minute. People are tailoring on the sets as well. So there's so much of the back work that goes on. Anything with entertainment or design is completely empty without any craftsperson. They are the backbone of whatever we do. I thought this was the time to pay tribute to something that is still such an integral part of my life. So then I came up with this whole theme of Bollywood. Each decade would be represented with a color. And those blockbuster films mentioned some interesting graffiti. That's what my masks are going to be. When I speak about the 40s and the 50s, besides the costume, the content, the music, and the classicness of black and white, what really I enjoyed was the art decor. This entire picture actually, which is from Mughlaiyaz, I mean, it's so beautifully crafted, but look at all the pillars, look at all the workmanship. And I'm just trying to sketch out arches. I mean, this is a complete rough sketch. Arches and have the black and white strokes, which are almost like those black and white curtains. You know, when the curtains open and there was this black and white movies. The 90s is a changing time, according to me. Salman, Aamir, Shah Rukh, they were the heroes who came in the 90s. Then there were iconic directors who came in, Ram Gopal Varma, Aditya Chopra, Karan Johar, and the entire look styling changed. It's from 2010 when smaller cities took center stage and the characters would wear utility clothes, literally mixing their culture. So wearing a kurta with a denim jacket, wearing a t-shirt with a salwar, and it started with the film Jab We Met. I think I'm going to leave the 2020 mask half done. Half, which is different kind of cinema today. It's not just a superstar in the film. There are just these new talented actors and filmmakers who are getting center stage as well. Today, women actors have strong roles. The women generally have a very strong voice, which is such a welcoming change. So for me, the red bindis are celebrating women. But the other half, I'm going to keep it black. So that time can fill some beautiful cinema, beautiful color, beautiful clothes, beautiful fashion, beautiful moments after this lockdown. 1990 to now, 2020, it's been a roller coaster journey. When you kind of get into a business and get into an organization, and there are so many people, so many voices, you know, the whole look is set for a brand. And then we become victims of that. We've got to compile to that look. Oh, you're a glamour brand and you can only be doing glamour. And then that experimental stops because you fear that, oh my God, but I have stores to fill in. I have clients to attend to. But I think I'm not going to fear anymore. I'm going to go by my heart. Stepping out of the expected box. And there's always that chance of it not being successful or being successful. But I want to take that chance.
You like the close-up one only, right?
Yeah, the close-up one.
Hello?
Can you hear us now? Hello.
One last shot, not a title shot?
The title shot, yeah.
This also you want off-center?
And look into the camera, looking towards the camera.